Hello. You are on the channel Chord of CG Computer Graphics. In this video you will learn about the interface in Substance Painter. Subscribe to the channel. Let's open the Substance Painter program. Let's create a new project. The model to be textured. In this tab, we will select a shader for it. It can be Unreal Engine, Unity, and so on. Here we select the resolution of the texture. Texture resolution can be changed in the project itself. Next, select here Oppingler Dirks. It depends on where the textures will be loaded. You can add a baking map if you have them. Click OK. A model has appeared. The first window is our viewport. Here is the 3D model. If you hold Alt and the left mouse button in the viewport, you can rotate the model. Alt the right mouse button is the scale of the object, and Alt the middle mouse button is the movement. The next window is the unfolding of the model. Unwrapping for Substance Painter is required. Without it, texturing won't work. In this window, you can choose on which sweep you will draw. In new videos I will show how to divide the model into different sweeps. If you need such a video, write in the comments plus. This is the Layers tab. For example, let's create a layer. Layer settings appear below. If you pick up a brush, the brush settings will be displayed here. Let's move on to the texture settings. Here you can bake the texture. We will talk more about baking in another lesson. Here we also select the resolution of the baked textures. Turn on the padding, and check the box here as there is no high poly model. Click on baked goods. What are baked cards for? For example, if a smart material is loaded on the layer. Smart stuff requires baked cards. With their help causes the appearance of spots, recesses and various properties. Also in the tab there are ordinary materials that do not require baked cards. There are also smart masks, filters that can be added to the layer. By right-clicking on the layer, here we select filters. There are many different kinds of brushes, alpha maps and environments. To change the environment, simply drag any HDR into the viewport. And to rotate it, we hold down the shift and the right mouse button. Go to the tool tabs. This is a brush. We can see that it doesn't draw anything because our layer is at the bottom. Move it to the top. Next comes the eraser tool. This is a projection tool. Let's throw any picture in the base color, and now we can reflect it on the model. Select the location on the model where this layer will be visible. Above is the brush setting. Here you can choose the size of the brush itself. Adjust the intensity of the brush. Add to required interval. You can also enable the lazy mouse counterpart and ZBrush. With it, you can draw exactly on the model. This is the viewport selection. Camera orientation settings. Project render. You can enable symmetry. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe to the channel. Bye.